So in this video, we're going to explain how we mount the well kit hair. The video is done with two different mountings. There are different models exist from a well, from 3 to 6 kilowatt, and it exists gas only or gas and electric 230 volt. So gas only work on LPG, on propane, and the gas and electric work as well on 230 volt, which means if you can use a short power in a campsite, you can use 3 kilowatt, up to 3 kilowatt, I think, from the electric, so you save a lot of gas. We particularly like this hair heater. Well, it's very, very efficient, but the fact it's under slung mounting, it's totally matched to save space in our camper van conversion. So it's perfect. And the fact it's outside as well make it noiseless. So it's good for the night. And it's lightweight and it's perfect, work perfectly for us. So as I said, in this video is done with two different heat hair. One works only on gas and the other one works on gas and electric. It's very similar process, and let me explain you how we do. So in the box, first the instruction. This is a heater, so this model is only LPG, the exhaust. So this is the bracket that we mount on the side of the van, under the van, the exhaust, the bracket, as I said, the filter for air coming in, and you've got all the plate for the mounting bracket under slung and all what you need. And the electric with the control panel, that is quite nice.
In top of this, you will need 65 mm blow air ducting and the wall vents, one or two, depends what you need. You also need 90 mm duct, a minimum of 1 meter. You will cut it in two and you need a minimum of 50 cm both sides for air in and air out. Plus the Jubilee clip, 90 mm. There is two type of bracket, the Z bracket and the U bracket. So this is a Z bracket. It's really straightforward. You just go in the little line, the black line like this. You can, depending on where your exhaust is going to be, you can put the heater in three different positions. The exhaust can go to the left, to the right, or underneath. So then you screw every part, the screws are provided. You have a 4 anti-vibration bracket provided with a washer and a nut. So you simply put in one in every corner. So once you decided the location of the space heater, you're ready to mark the point to be drilled. In this situation, it's a long wheelbase printer, and it's located just behind the driver. It's a right side driver, it's a UK vehicle. So, and it's good to be two persons, one to hold the space heater and the other one to mark the point to be drilled. So we do the hole where we've been marking the place to drill. So we first use a small drill bit and then we will use a larger one to be able to pass the M8 bolt and screw. The supply of heating air must not be contaminated by exhaust fumes from the heater or any other source in the vehicle. The inlet must be protected by a grille or other suitable means and installed in such a way that it cannot be obstructed by other objects. Ducting must be fitted to prevent access to moving parts. So this is the location under the sofa where is a water tank. And on the left side, this is a place the air is going to go out. Regarding the flue installation, the exhaust outlet must be positioned in such a way that the exhaust gases may not enter the vehicle interior or the external living space. The diagram provided is really clear. To make it short, not under the doors, window, and neither close to the fuel filling point. So for the exhaust, you must establish like an initial rise for the flue and then a drop down to facilitate the evacuation of the smoke, which is facilitated by the size of the bracket. There are some short and longer one. So of course you use the first short and then the longest one. Then the bracket is simply mounted under the van. And to attach the air filter, there is a bracket number two on the draw provided, and the clip is provided too. So on the left, you can see the exhaust of the heat air, and on the right, it's the well expanse water heater. So let's stay on the left, and you can see the exhaust mounted. If you have a 3GT model, you can have only one fixed vent. If it's another model, you need at least two. So this is the second one that is going to go to the shower. So this is a hole to pass the duct 65 millimeters. So in our situation, the space heat 5GT is located under the tank. You have here the Y connection, so from 90 millimeter ducting to the 65 millimeter ducting. So one is going behind the wall, and you have the fixed vent located just here. And the other one is going under the van with a foam insulation and a protection for the rain, and is located in the shower, which is really comfortable to have a hot shower in winter. It's amazing. So this sprinter has a refillable LPG tank. It's a 30 liter capacity and it's located instead of the spare wheel. Here you can see the 8 millimeter copper pipe supplying the LPG to the heat air and with just simply attached to the heat air with a 8 mil compressor. And then the electric pipe. So the copper pipe arrive here under the sofa and going all along the kitchen to go back to the manifold connected to the underslung tank. So in the jackbox, there's a connection for the heat air and the water expense. So you have cable running under the van and going to the fuse board. And there is a 16 amps circuit breaker. You can use as well 16 amps fuse. And it's also connected to a protective hearse.